from the crypt. Oh, hello, kiddies. Tonight's coffin caper is so crammed with ghastly greed, sickening sex, and vomitous violence that parental guidance is advised. So, guide your parents out of the room so we can have some fun! This tale concerns a gambling man with a bad case of double vision who's about to hit the hackpot. I call this twin helping of horror split personality.
The buzzer took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on a square. The buzzer tried to throw the monkey off his back. The monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Well, the buzzer told the monkey, you are choking me. Release your hold and I'll set you free." The monkey looked the buzzer right dead in the eye. Said, "Your story's touching, but it sounds like a lie."
Hit me. I'm sorry, I'm new at this. These green chips are worth $5, right?
$50, sir.
No. I made a mistake. I meant they should be fives. I bet five.
Bet's on the table, sir.
No, but I made a mistake.
Bet's on the table.
But I made a mistake. I can't afford this much. You don't understand.
I'm sorry, sir. House rules, there's nothing I can do.
Hit me.
19. Dealer could have 20. Would you like another card, sir?
Look, you're not going to believe this, but my kid, you know, he can't take care of himself. Now they tell me he has this kidney thing, and the insurance won't cover the medical, because I had some trouble in the Army when I was in NAM.
Would you like another card, sir?
Go ahead. You make blackjack on the next card, the house pays 5-1. You're rich, Ace.
That's if he gives me a 2.
100 says it is. You got more to lose.
Oh, what the hell?
Deal me a 2.
There you go.
Whoa. No, that's for your boy's operation.
Kidding, I didn't understand the game, huh?
No, I can't take it.
Oh, it's the least I can do.
I don't know what to say, Dan.
Don.
Listen, Don. It's very kind of you, but I cannot accept it. You keep that. My gut tells me you need that a lot more than I do. And my gut never lies, like knowing that 2 was waiting for you. Let me tell you something, Ace, 2's my lucky number. Double your pleasure, 2 heads are better than 1, all that shit. The best things in life come in 2's. You understand what I'm saying?
Make it 2 doubles.
Look, Don. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm not in the best financial shape, but I can still call out a favor or 2. And I know for a fact you need a wad for your medical expenses. So here's the deal. I got an inside line on a no-risk, tax-free, limited partnership investment. Guaranteed to double our money. Minimum 10 grand. You keep that cash. Write me a personal check now. Give me your address and your phone number. Inside 2 weeks, we're sitting pretty. Your boy gets his operation. We call it two friends doing each other a favor. What do you say, Dan?
Done.
And how would you like that, sir?
Hundreds will be just fine. Always a pleasure, Jimmy.
Don't mention it, Slick.
I got to get out of this shithole. I'm so tired of dodging feds. Sweet talking old ladies out of their rainy day cash. One of these days, I'm gonna settle down. I'm gonna make that big con. Who knows? Maybe I'll even get married.
Did you pay me to fuck or listen to your life story?
Shut up! Shut the fuck up! I pay you to be whatever! I remember the first time I saw that picture, The Parent Trap, with Haley Mills. I used to pop a Woody every time I saw those two do a scene together. I always wanted to make it with twins.
Katarina. When we kiss, pretty miss, I'm in ecstasy. Oh, how happy my heart would be if I knew that you loved just me. Say it's true, say it do, Katarina.
Son of a bitch.
Talk about a warm welcome. What the fuck is this piece of shit? Come in. Thank you. Don't mind if I do. Hello? Etchison Dobbs Blair. What a goofy looking fuck he was.
Don't move! Unless you want your brains all over Daddy's picture. How did you get in here anyways?
Oh, take it easy, okay? I just had a little accident down the road. All I want to do is use your telephone. I just want to make a phone call. I'll be out of your hair with two shakes. I promise.
I'm April. That's June.
What happened to May? Excuse me. Part of my frail attempt at a little levity at a moment like this. I just want to use the telephone, okay? Don't do nothing. Thank you. See? Just want to use the phone. Really have a beautiful home here. In fact, next to the Case Observatory up in Oak Valley, I think that this house might be Blair's greatest architectural achievement. German expressionist influence, 50s futurism.
You knew who our father was?
Are you kidding? The man was a genius. If you look at a copy of Who's Who in architecture, your father's the only listing. You understand what I'm saying? I mean, I don't know anybody who took the influence of the Bauhaus school and adapted it better to his own unique style. Psh! That guy was unbelievable. Hello? Yeah, I need a tow truck.
Do that later. You've been in an accident.
Well, it wasn't a serious accident. You know, I just bumped my head. The tire blew out. What's your name again?
I'm April.
April, it's a pleasure to meet you. Nice very to nice to see you. What's your sister's name? What's your name?
June.
June, very nice to see you.
We don't have many visitors.
Really? Girls as beautiful as you, too? I find that hard to believe.
Oh, the occasional architectural journal, but most people think we're naive. They'd love to take advantage of us.
Really?
Don't tell me you didn't know we were worth $2 billion.
So there I was, a set piece, with my good friend Preston Chatfield of the Hyannisport Chatfields. And I'm ready to make a bid on this exquisite nouveau lamp. And all of a sudden, I noticed the tiniest little scratch on the finish. I said, oh, my cat did that 2 years ago. That lamp used to be in my collection. Could you imagine?
You like cats?
Do I like cats? Are you kidding? Sometimes I trust cats more than I do people.
Somebody call for a tow truck?
I knew it was too good to last. Well, ladies, thank you very much for your hospitality. I hope I didn't cause too much of an inconvenience. I am truly humble.
Mr. Stetson, my sister and I, if you'd care to come by again.
I figured I must have died and went to heaven. At first, I really couldn't figure out why a couple of rich babes like that would hold up like hermits. But hey, when fish come to you already in a barrel, guy can't complain too much. So I went to work.
Everybody loves somebody sometime. Everybody falls in love somehow. Something in your kiss just told me my sometime is not.
And slowly but surely, they started to come out of whatever shells they were in. I'm talking a couple of icebergs starting to thaw out.
There's no telling where love may appear. Something in my heart keeps saying.
I was reeling them in all right.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking? I only wish there were two of them.
Then the day came I had to make my move. I had to get each of them alone. And when I did, boy, that's when things got real interesting.
You see, Daddy designed both bedrooms exactly alike. Like two sides of a mirror. Kind of like me and June.
Oh, yeah? Where is June, anyway?
April? Oh, she went out. Hasn't been out of the house in months. June's always been a little more outgoing than me anyways. We never needed to go out before Daddy died. We fought over him constantly. But now we have each other.
You two are pretty close, aren't you?
Inseparable. Until now.
She seems sweet.
Oh, she is. Unless you cross her.
Come again?
Well, I mean, everyone has a dark side, don't they? Besides, you don't see much.
She got a temper, huh?
Almost like a split personality.
Get out of here. I can't see your sister or you hurting a fly.
You don't know the half of it.
Look, I would never say this to her. So it's gotta be our little secret, okay?
My sister and I don't have secrets. We share everything. 50-50.
But this might hurt her feelings. You don't want to do that, do you? See, I'm afraid you two ain't exactly identical.
What do you mean?
Newsflash. One of you is just a little more beautiful, than the other. And no offense, honey, but for a couple of wallflowers who don't get out much, they still make you look like a nun. So now I got them both in the palm of my hand. Either one of them will marry me in a New York minute. All I gotta do is pop the question. But that only gets me half the fortune. They both got equal say in every cent. 50-50. The only way I can get it all is if I marry both of them. And the only way I could do that is if there were two of me!
A twin brother?
I know, it seems like a stupid coincidence. I guess I was embarrassed to bring it up till now.
Where is he? What's his name?
His name is Jack. He's in South Africa. We have some pretty important holdings there, and business demands that one of us stay there at all times. So he stays there a month, I spot him the next, and so on. And we trade off.
Does this mean you're leaving?
I'm afraid so. But it's only for a month. Besides, look, my brother will be home in a few days. I already told him about you two. Maybe he could drop around for a little visit. But I must warn you, though, he's a little more outgoing than I am. He's not as educated or well-spoken. You know, he talks that California jargon, and he's very flamboyant. Whoa, ladies. Vic told me you were a couple of radical babes, but I must confess to being totally stoked and overwhelmed. You dig? I'm too sexy for Milan. Too sexy for Milan.
Do you, April Dobbs Blair, take this man to have and to hold in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Do you, June Etchison Blair, take this man to honor and cherish in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Then by the powers vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Bingo.
Every star's a wishing star.
Oh! Hey! Shut that! Charlie Chan, excuse me, I don't mean to intrude, but I like to catch a few Z's over here, it's okay? You don't mind, do you go play someplace else, okay? Sorry. See? Nice and quiet. Calm, serene, it's beautiful. Thank you very much. Life's a bitch, ain't it, Wong?
Are you thinking what I'm thinking? That we can finally put the past behind us? We deserve to be happy, you know. Daddy would have wanted it this way. I only wish both our husbands could be with us at the same time. We could always share. Darling, why can't I come with you to South Africa?
I told you, it's hot, it's sticky, you'd hate it.
Well, when's your brother coming back anyways? June misses him so much, she's beside herself.
Tomorrow night. Why is this stupid drawer always locked? What the hell's in it anyway? Where's my shirt? Oh, thank you.
Honey.
What?
You're back.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So I got a little sunburn. Sun's a lot hotter in South Africa, let me tell you.
Let me tell you, the man is an animal. Last night, he tied me to the bed when we, you know, and it wasn't the first time either. You're kidding. Vic does that to me, too.
No.
I guess they're like in all sorts of ways, aren't they? When Jack took off his shirt for bed, his back was all tanned, except for this little pale strip. You're kidding. Just before Vic left for South Africa, he sunburned his back and he had the same thing.
Katarina! When we kiss, pretty miss, I'm an ecstasy. See, 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 Katarina. But when we kiss, pretty miss, are you thinking of me? Katarina. Just how long is the list? Oh, too sexy for my hair, too sexy for this earring, too sexy, too sexy for this house, too sexy. Hey, honey, you two bitchin' babes better be getting dressed to kill, because I'm taking you out for the most awesome feast ever. Blair twins question the death of architect. Foul play suspected in death of architect. Get the fuck out. Twins acquitted of father's death by juvenile court. You got to be fucking kidding.
What's going on? Hey, what are you doing? Huh? What the fuck you doing? Let me go. Let me go. What are you doing? What the fuck are you doing?
Hello, darling.
Okay. Okay, so I was in love with the both of you. Big deal. What was I supposed to do, huh? Hey, did I make you both happy? Tell the truth. Did I make you both happy? Come on. Hey, I don't know about that thing with your father. You know, I'm not saying you did anything, but, I mean, even if you did, what the fuck is the difference? What do I care, huh? You were young. You were girls. You're frivolous little kids. Come on, huh? Who gives a shit what you did?
But we did do it, Vic. We shared everything. But we didn't want to share him anymore. It was too hard, one of him and two of us. We were too selfish. Like now.
Where you going? Where's she going? Where's she going? Hey! Hey! Where you going? What's she doing?
I'm gonna let her do the honors.
What honors?
She was always the moral going of the two of us. Right, Jack?
Hey! Hey! Come on, huh? Fucking screwball!
I'm the buzzer took a monkey for a ride in the air.
It's all right now, honey. It's all right.
Throw the monkey off his back. The monkey grabbed his neck and said, now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right.
Everything's going to be all right from now on.
Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of jiving? Straighten up and fly right.
Guess old Venal Vic thought he could double his fun and his bank account. Too bad he was only half right. Oh well, it just proves the old saying, behind every bad man, there's two women. With a chainsaw! So, kiddies, care for a little meme of chance? Deads, I win. Tails, you ooze. Coffin Caper is so crammed with ghastly greed, sickening sex, and vomitous violence that parental guidance is advised. So, guide your parents out of the room so we can have some fun! This tale concerns a gambling man with a bad case of double vision who's about to hit the hackpot. I call this twin helping of horror Split Personality.
The buzzard took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on a square. The buzzard tried to throw the monkey off his back. The monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack, straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top." Well, the buzzard told the monkey